Hello and welcome to another CF Power Scripts tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. Today I'm going to walk you through the setup of Google's reCaptcha in version 3. Now, unlike the Google reCaptcha version 2 scripts, we'll actually need not only a side key, but also a secret key, because Google's reCaptcha version 3 works slightly different than the previous version. Instead of automatically declining or accepting people and deciding if they are a bot, Google actually shifts the decision to you. It only assigns a score from 0 to 1, and it leaves it up to you to decide which score a user has to have in order to be able to submit your form, which also provides you with more flexibility and allows you to adjust the strictness of Google's reCaptcha script to find the sweet spot between preventing bots and also preventing humans on occasion from submitting your form. Now, in order to set this up, all you need is a CF Power Scripts account, and once you're in there, you simply click on Add New Script and you select the reCaptcha version 3 script and click on Next. Now, by the time you are doing this, there's already going to be the video here that you're currently watching, as well as a detailed description that walks you through the process. Now, in order to set up the script, the next thing we need to do is we need to get our Google reCaptcha site and secret keys. And for that, we have to head to Google's reCaptcha website, log into the admin console, and create a new site. Now, you have to give that site a name and select reCaptcha version 3, and you have to add your funnels domain, which is the domain that you can find here inside your funnel without any HTTPS or slashes. And you'll also need to add app.clickfunnels.com. So the reCaptcha script also works when you preview your funnels. Now, if you're adding this script not only to one specific funnels, but to your global scope, so to all funnels at once, you need to make sure that you add the domains of all your funnels here. Otherwise, the script will not work properly. Now, once you've done that, you simply have to accept the terms and submit the form, and it will show you your site and your secret key. I'm not going to do that because I already created a site. So I'm going to instead select that existing reCaptcha version 3 site and go to the settings to copy my site and secret key. So I simply copy the site key, go back to CF Power Scripts and paste it, and copy the secret key, go back again and paste it. Now the next thing is to define the threshold. So the score from 0.0 to 1.0 that decides if a user is allowed to opt in. Now, almost no visitor ever will have a 1.0 straight away, and I recommend that you start with a 0.5 here, and after you've had some traffic on your funnel, you can head to Google's reCaptcha's dashboard, and you will see the number of requests, the date they happened, and the score distribution, which will allow you to adjust the threshold. So if you get some bot opt-ins or spammy opt-ins, but you see that most of your traffic anyway has a 0.9, then simply increase the score setting from 0.5 to 0.678. So you make sure to filter out more of the negative traffic. Now, for now, we're just going to save it with a 0.5, and we're going to click Add Script to add that script to all of our funnels. Now, in my ClickFunnels account, when I open this opt-in page here in the preview mode, and I refresh the page to make sure we have the latest version of the Power Script included, we can see that the Protected by reCaptcha badge is added to the funnel, and your funnel is now actually protected. So every time somebody tries to opt in, it's now going to basically first confirm Google's reCaptcha score and make sure that it's above your threshold. That's how easy you can add version 3 of Google's reCaptcha to your funnel. Now, if you're curious about the differences between version 2 and version 3 and so on, I recommend you check out our YouTube channel. We'll have a quite good video there explaining the differences between the two versions and the benefits and downsides of each one. Now, don't forget, if you ever have any issues whatsoever, take a look at our FAQ, and if you cannot find the answer there, reach out to us through our contact form. We are more than happy to help you with all your technical issues. Thanks for watching, and thanks for using CF Power Scripts. See you in our next tutorial. Till then, bye-bye.